Hi there, YouTubers. This is Serap Khosi Online here. You can follow me on Twitter if you just want to get details about Sunday's internet. Also at Khosi Online on Twitter. Just turn on my notifications if you are interested in gaming. Those Twitter followers that you would normally get. I also do have a Facebook presence. Just go on there at Khosi Online and like my Facebook page. We also at Sunday's internet are on Facebook. Find us there and like our Facebook page. Also follow at Sunday's internet on Twitter. So with that all out of the way, today's video is just going to be all about wave physics, the way Wi-Fi is connected to your Bluetooth and waves. So that's the whole idea of today's video, just to understand the origin of Wi-Fi. So before watching this video, be sure to click the subscribe button down there if you are using your mobile, and enable bell notifications, because YouTube's algorithm might not show you every time after we've uploaded a new video. So just keep that in mind. With all that out of the way, let's just jump into today's video, shall we? Okay guys, waves and radiation is some of the things that we can just say they have been there forever on Earth since the Big Bang Theory and the start of the universe. So if you are wondering where would this waves and radiation be at this time and age in 2018, you might as well just be certain that these radio waves are being used by some of our home appliances, such as microwaves. Microwave, they cook food and they just need that bandwidth just to connect to that wave and cook food for your microwave. Obviously, the particles are well insulated on the microwave so that none of them just escape the microwave and become harmful to anyone. That's just why they are so well insulated. And one other thing that you can just look at is the other uses of this bandwidth of 2400 megahertz. Amongst other things, it's being used by car alarm sensors, Bluetooth devices, and live video feeds. They all use that 2.4 gigahertz bandwidth spectrum. So now this bandwidth spectrum comes along with many advantages, outweighing the advantages of using a 5 gigahertz bandwidth spectrum. Mind you guys that these kind of bandwidth spectrum, they are far away different from networks, 3G networks, 2G and 4G networks. Those that they've got nothing to do with those ones. Those are just cellular mobile technology. So we are not concentrating on that one. We are just concentrating on radio signal waves. Those are the ones that we just use just to connect to our public Wi-Fi hotspot. Now the question might arise, when are you connected and how are you connected and what kind of speed are you connected in? No, just wait. The whole thing can be explained on the display of your Android device or your iPhone. So it will thus display the graphic mode of your connection. So the graphic mode and the numeric mode on an iPhone, they don't just present the same results, because the numeric mode, they don't give you the real actual connection. So graphic mode just show you how much are you connected. So someone can just ask, how much is the connectivity on there? Just been checking out there. Okay, one thing that I can just tell you is that Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, from physics, the strength is measured in decibels. That's what we use for sound. So if you want to measure sound, like just in a workplace, like in a plant or a mine, metallurgical operations, those kind of operations or chemical processes, so there's this kind of thing of measuring the wavelength of the sound. So that's what you call the decibels. Anyway, Wi-Fi is even measured in decibels. You might as well just notice that if you are on numeric mode when using your iPhone or your Android, then it shows you it's negative 120 decibels. That means that you've got a weak signal. That signal is very weak. You might as well just have to change position and become closer to the Wi-Fi. So now, if that graphic mode or numeric mode on your device again is showing you negative 80, it really means that at least there is a connection. So now, these decibels, they are used as technologists, we use them just to measure the strength of your Wi-Fi connection. Even just goes on for sound. Those guys who are doing sound engineering, they might as well just be using these decibels because it's all about just how to balance the surrounding sound. Not to dwell much on sound engineering, guys. Your wave, the way it's so insulated, so most people just think that these waves are harmful. What I can just tell you that those waves are not harmful. Some of them they are. Mind you that you've got lots of different waves. X-rays, microwaves, gamma rays, alpha rays, infrared, including that one. Because before Bluetooth, in the early 2010s, we were using this infrared just to connect to someone and just share files among. So in today's technology, we're not using infrared because of its proximity base. It only transfers files through direct connection. Now, the latest Bluetooth, according to connections, you can connect even a person is across the room, or if you are living in an apartment complex whereby you just need file sharing, or maybe if you are roaming, you are around. So now there's lots of different uses that you can just explain about this Bluetooth device. But the whole thing about this magnetic background radiation has been there forever is that most people now think that Wi-Fi, just because it radiates, they think that it's harsh and harmful. Oh, those are big words, gigabytes of radiation. So some of the people can think that it's harmful. So on this video, I'm just gonna explain to you, like, those gigabytes and radiation, those things, they just only depends on the type of material that we're using. As you can just notice that as technologists, we use lots of material. So most of them, they are not reachable to the ionization energy level. So if you know anything about this ionization, maybe did some chemistry there, it's all about the energy required just to break an atom, just to ions. Just for an example, taking table salt. Table salt can be broken into sodium plus and chlorine minus. So if you break that carbon into those ions, it's going to be ionized. So remember that everything, they just have to ionize. In this instance of physics, we're talking about light reflecting on an object. So now this object is going to ionize and change the charge on the object. So it could be positive or negative. So that's what we call ionization in physics, compared to in chemistry, whereby it is the energy that is required just to break that table salt. So if you get the difference, more or less is the same thing. But on physics, we are too much concerned about the refraction of light through objects. So now, if you don't know anything about the level of radiation and what it can just do, you can take just for a plain mirror, for example. then shovel about 1,000 watts of power of light on that and stand in front of that mirror. It's the same process that the microwave uses just to cook food. So if you can stand in front of that mirror, that wave is going to bang you, and no microwave is needed there whatsoever. So guys, you can just have a look at this in too many ways. And this Wi-Fi, if you think that they are harmful, just let me know down there on the comment section which are other harmful materials that you think that I should review for you. X-rays, they have not yet reached the ionization level state. That's just why we can X-ray your body and just have a look in the internal parts of your body without even harming you. So that's one of the great features of non-ionization radiation level. Your sunglasses, some of them, they have got UV radiation. So that UV radiation, it all depends on whether you just want the higher one or the lower one. Normally, the basic idea behind that one is that light, sunlight shouldn't damage your eye. Hence, we have got those glasses which are made for that non-ionization image. So we can talk about this Wi-Fi. Why is it not harmful? Why are people saying that too much time spending on Wi-Fi is harmful? But I'm saying that it's not harmful. So here's the reason why. Just take a normal light bulb, a candescent light bulb, which is about 100 watts. That light emits energy, radiating energy for about 100 watts. So that is the power, that the light energy is given there. So now just compare to Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi doesn't emit much energy. The only energy that is there is only by the frequency of connection. So you can imagine that the light bulb is way too harmful than the original, maybe the Wi-Fi connection on that one. So you can look at it in these many ways if you want. But connecting to a simple Wi-Fi and spending too much time on it, it doesn't become health hazard. So now, if you are wondering, just like from the previous comments on the video that you just made about this connection to Wi-Fi and the harmfulness, you can be rest assured that this Wi-Fi won't damage you. And again, concerning wave physics, we're too much concerned about the Bluetooth. Now, Bluetooth technology in 2018 has so much advanced in such a way that they are now considering Bluetooth as a matchup for a Wi-Fi connection. Just gonna be used as an alternative to Wi-Fi, because Bluetooth nowadays has advanced in so astronomical measure, in such a way that the Bluetooth 5 even announced that they are going to be interning concerning on the Internet of Things, IoT. So what that normally means is that in the future, basic products, we don't have a screen or a Wi-Fi connection, or basically they don't have anything but to do with connecting to a Wi-Fi. They'll be able to connect through Bluetooth and the Wi-Fi. So for instance, let's just take a robotic vacuum cleaner. That thing, it has got a small screen. And some of the home products that you're going to be connecting, you're also going to be connecting those ones which don't even have screens for display, or they don't have a, they doesn't make sense just to have a screen on those devices. So they are going to connect to that Wi-Fi. Coming to a robotic vacuum cleaner, that product is gonna have an NFR3 coding. So the coding is going to connect to a Wi-Fi hotspot, then you connect to the Wi-Fi Bluetooth again, and the devices work. Unlike just right now, whereby we are struggling with connection to those devices which they don't have Wi-Fi. So guys, I think I just have to stop it right here. And just let me know If you enjoyed this video as much as I did, and if you want to continue watching, I'll post the links here of Sunday's internet so that you can click on those. And if you enjoyed them, just give me a thumbs up there. That would be awesome. Thank you guys for watching. See you next time. Have a nice one.